Hey guys, you must have heard about automatic generation of news and articles. It is also termed as automatic journalism or the robot reporter. In AI industry, artificial intelligence industry, this is a hot topic now. Purpose of the talk today is to give you some information what is happening around. This is more sort of information video and not a programmatic video, but I believe many people will find this information useful. First, let me give you an overview what I'm going to cover today. I'll tell you about some of the places where you can find automatic generated news if you have not discovered till now today. Then I'll tell you about some of the common dangers. If you do not have automated tools, then how can you actually, whatever you are reading is actually authentic or not, how you can check manually. And finally, I'll give you some of the community efforts that AI community is doing for detection of the fake news. And this is the last slide for which this context has been made in all other slides. And Iran's Revolutionary Guards said to Friday that they had captured a British flag oil tanker in the Gulf after the United Kingdom seized an Iranian ship this month, using tension along a key international oil shipping route. Now you can see this is a perfect grammar. This seems to be written by a human, but this actually is written by a machine. It is generated by artificial intelligence piece of software that understands the linguistic meanings of the words and sentences to avoid any grammatical mistakes. I must say that this is very surprising and awesome that machine learning industry has reached to this height to generate such beautiful looking and real looking text. But it creates some serious concerns that machines are generating. But before that, I jump onto the dangers. Let me show you some more articles, some more places where you can find this automatic generated news. These whatever news you are seeing here is a fake news, and you can see people have also commented on them too. Another article is published by The Guardian, and the news that you are seeing here with the graph is generated by machine. This news is generated by Washington Post, where it has posted something about the game. Newsomatic. If you run any WordPress blog or WordPress site, then Newsomatic actually is a plugin that has been given, which actually can generate the automatic articles for you, and that can be simply automatically posted on your site. Such a great automation has been done. So monarch.com, Newsomatic, we have talked about newship.com. newship.com was used by Associated Press in 2013, 6 years before, to generate the automatic news. Washington Post, a news that you have just seen, is using Heliograph. You have already seen a Guardian post as well. Narrative Science is a company which is using natural language generation techniques of artificial intelligence and machine learning, and they are really producing good product these days. And there are multiple others. It is not an exhaustive list. Now let's talk about some problems. The first problem that with the automatic news is whether this is a fact based or somebody has just cooked anything. I mean, the machine simply started writing, and this does not make any context, right, with the actual fact. So this is very important to know whether the article that you are reading is actually truth or not. And the machine actually can highlight some data which actually is not relevant. Suppose you are talking about some religion or politics, and it is highlighting some article, it is putting some text in bold, which actually can create tension between two parties, whether it is part of the actual context or not. That's also a problem with the machine generated data. Errors may get undetected. In humans, there are auditors sitting who read the news before it gets published. But in case of machines, they may or they may not put a auditing machine. And if the auditing machine itself is a machine, then it can also make the same mistake. This is an ethical issue. Another problem is whether a subject is appropriate or not. Suppose you are talking about politics or religion, just like I told you. This is so sensitive. These are so sensitive topics that these should be properly audited. If you are talking about cricket or something, that may or may not be okay. But if you are talking about sex, religion, and politics, this can be very serious issues if you are going to generate something wrong. Another ethical issue. Hackers may use these kind of softwares who will generate and spread a lot of misinformation. Suppose they are going to some trade, just there is something wrong is going on in a company, the stock price may go down drastically. And suppose company is going to push an information that this is a fake news or there is no problem with the company, then in the flood of information, the actual information can spread, the prices can go down. This is an example of financial hack that I'm telling you, and there it can have multiple other serious issues. Another one, machines may are getting intelligent, but they are dumb too. There is a software generated which has beaten human in the Go game, but it still does not understand whether it is playing Go or it's playing a golf. It just understands the pattern that it is seeing on the board. Another example is deepfake. Deepfake was a software created by someone which actually generate nude pictures of women and keeping their faces just intact. This is such an ethical issue. Many organizations, many places have banned this deepfake implementation, deepfake project. Using deepfake, this is actually a computer vision program, but also it has a similar implications. People or hackers are also generating the fake pictures of CEOs, famous personalities like presidents or prime ministers to portray something which actually is not true. This is just the starting. I'm not against what artificial intelligence community is doing. Only thing is, it should be audited properly. It should be ethical. And you as a user, as the consumer of all these tools, all these softwares, you should also be aware, and you should only an aware user can actually take the right decision. Now let's talk about, suppose you do not have an automated tools, how you are going to detect that whatever you are reading is actually truth or not. These are some of the techniques that I'm giving you. First of all, when any article or anything you are reading on your mobile or on your laptop, you need to check whether what is the source. Is it from someone you know, any human, personally you know, or it is actually from a organization which takes the liability of providing that news. These days there are so many news apps have come which actually are spreading a lot of fake information, and this is really a serious issue when people are believing it. I also have seen and posted and forwarded many news articles from the news sites, and then other people told me that this is a fake news because they have proven using some actual sites that see, this is the real news. You should always see whether the source is authentic or not. Identify which site is giving you actually a fake news, and you should stop reading from that site. Check the headlines, whether they are in the context of whatever you are reading or not. This is a common problem with the buggy software who are generating this kind of code. And one common problem is the dates. Whatever news you are reading is actually recent or it is a years old news. And WhatsApp, actually this is happening a lot. People are reading news and believing that this is what is happening around us, but this is not truth. This has happened 3-4 or even 10 years before. Also check the author, check whether what are the facts. Suppose somebody is talking about some politics, just try to find out real some facts from other places. Also try to figure out what assumptions is being made by the author. Sponsorship: when there is a lot of news headlines are there, they generally write sponsored, a very small gray word, that it is sponsored. You are going to believe that is a news, but actually is an ad. Other companies are giving their ad, showing you something which lucrate you to just see into this and believe what it is, but actually it's a sponsored ad. It is not a news article. Some AI or machine learning techniques to detect whether it's a fake news or not: find out the patterns, wrong patterns. Generally, if it is being generated by software, they always use a specific pattern. If you can detect those patterns, actually Facebook is using that. They are checking specific keywords and specific patterns to find out what are the news articles generated, what are the news articles or whatever the text that is there is a machine generated or not. Also check for the grammar. Google also has released one tool which says which is called as Google Fact Checker. When it is showing some news, it also gives you a link and you can just click it, and it'll tell you whether the information provided into this link is fact or not. AI community, artificial intelligence and machine learning community, is doing a lot of hard work to tackle this challenge. One is, let me show you something. These are some of the individual contributions. There are many people who are doing it. This guy has tried to develop some end-to-end product wherein you can just pay some content. It is calling it as a fake box. You provided the URL and the text of article, and it will tell you whether it is fake or not. Another effort by this author is also good, where he's also trying to find out whether the information is fake, whether the news is fake or not. And this is just the starting. If you Google for such kind of information, you'll find a lot of news articles, a lot of GitHub code, which are trying to detect whether news is fake or not. This is one of an example, fake buster, done by someone who actually has tried naive-Bayes spot vector machines, neural network using TensorFlow, neural network with Keras, LSTM, and he's got a decent accuracy on his test data, up to 94%. AI community also has provided a data set and a challenge, fakenewschallenge.org, from where, and other places also there where you can find the data set where data is labeled whether the news is fake or not. So here you can see they had made some challenge almost a few years before, and some people have done really good into detecting whether the news was fake or not on their provided challenge data set, test set, 82%. One data set you can also find on Kaggle. If you explore the data, you can find there are texts written, and there are multiple kernels as well where people have written to find out whether the news is fake or not. You can fork any kernel, or you can even write your own kernel to give it a try. Last and not least is a wonderful work done by Allen Institute. What they have done is code is available, but still they have not released the checkpoint for their neural network for automatic detection of fake news. They are still releasing it to the researchers only, not to public. Okay, so I can show you a demo here. First, it can, let's say why Bitcoin is a great investment or something, you can simply use these headings, write your own heading here, or take any example here, and you can simply generate it. As soon as you click the generate, its backend is going to generate a news article for you, which you can simply copy, paste on your website or anywhere. So this is a generation, and we are talking about detection. Okay, so it has generated an article on using the data, that using the seeds that you have provided, and it is a fake news. And this is a detect section of this demo. You can use any of the sample. I'll show you how to. Okay, let's use this sample and let's say detect fake news. What Grover is going to say whether this is written by a human or that is written by a machine. This is the same article that was generated on the generate page, and it says it is written by a machine. Let us test it on the actual text. Let us take this text, today's latest text. We are quite sure that this is written by a machine. This is really good, and actually it is impressive. This is much sophisticated, much advanced, and much reliable than other work done by the community people. But as they are still researching and they are still making it more robust, they have not released the code. But I hope we will see it soon available for us so that we can fight with this upcoming monster. So we have talked about some of the community efforts. This is just a starting. With the information that I have supplied you today, I just touched the surface. News generation is quite mature and old story now, and there are tons of discovery being done today to avoid the dangers. With this, I'll say best of luck for your research and fight against the dangers to humanity. Let's make an AI work for us rather than a Terminator. Thanks for watching.